In this video, we're going to look at how test crosses work. If we take an example of a plant and look at one trait such as flower color, we can look at how a test cross works. This trait is going to have two possible alleles, a dominant big R that codes for red flowers and a recessive little r that codes for white flowers. Genotype refers to the genetic makeup, in other words, the specific genes or alleles an individual has. There are three genotypes for this trait, big R, big R, big R, little r, and little r, little r. Even though there are three genotypes, there are only two phenotypes. Phenotype refers to the physical expression of the genes in an individual, in this case, either red flowers or white flowers. Those with two big R alleles only have alleles that code for red flowers and express this. Since big R is dominant over the recessive little r, in the big R little r plant, they would also express as having red flowers. Those with two recessive little r's would have white flowers. In this example of flower color, if we have a plant with white flowers, we know they must have two recessive alleles, as that is the only way the plant would be able to have white flowers. But if a plant has red flowers, it could be either big R big R or big R little r, as the big R for red flowers is dominant over the little r for white flowers. Test crosses allow a way to determine zygosity of whether a parent is homozygous dominant, big R, big R, or heterozygous, big R, little r, by looking at their offspring. This is done by crossing an individual expressing a dominant phenotype with an individual that we know for sure what the genotype is. The only individual that we know what their genotype is based on their phenotype is one that is expressing a recessive phenotype, as they must possess two recessive alleles to express the recessive trait. This is when we can utilize a Punnett square. If the parent being crossed with the homozygous recessive individual was being crossed with the homozygous dominant plant, then by using a Punnett square, we can see that any offspring from this cross would all be heterozygous and all express as having red flowers. On the other hand, if it was heterozygous big R little r and we use a second Punnett square, we can see from this cross that it would produce offspring that have red flowers, but it also produces offspring that have white flowers. The presence of offspring in a test cross would determine whether the parent was homozygous dominant or heterozygous by the presence or lack of offspring with white flowers. Thank you for watching. If you found this video helpful, be sure to subscribe and hit that like button.